on the Epic Robo channel. Okay, I think we might be live now. It says we're live. I'm sorry, this is usually Toodles' job, but he's in the Bermuda Triangle. So I finally figured it out, and I'm going to pass it off to the person that you all want to speak with, Wendy.
Oh, thank you, Peter. Yeah. Hi, everyone. Oh, boy. Let's see. So, camera is here, here, here.
Yeah, the camera's down
there.
There,
oh,
I think.
Hi.
Oh, and there's someone has set it up.
Oh, hey, Kay. So, yes, as Peter mentioned, we had a little technical difficulties. Apparently, we're not the ones that usually do this. And though our K-Cron tech staff is amazing, most of them had gone home already. So it was us trying to figure it out.
I take full blame for that responsibility.
No.
Dock it from my pay if you have to.
Please. But Toodles, we miss you a lot. You clearly do a lot of work around here. You can follow him on Twitter at ToodlesFML. Hi, everyone. Oh, my goodness. So as we go on, I'm going to do my best with this. Now, granted, usually I get to edit myself if I flub or take a little time to actually think of an answer that doesn't sound crazy. So if I come up with something crazy, just roll with it. live.
Someone likes your wallpaper.
Oh, thank you. We helped pick it out, but you know, it's just the office wallpaper. Yay. In our new our K-Cron revamp of the Chronicle. Now, I was really happy that some of you sent in questions ahead of time, so I was able to at least prep a few of these to get started. From Brazil, hello! As we go, if you happen to have any questions that you'd like me to try to address, be sure to send them in, and my assistant, Mr. Pan here, will try to pass them to me. And Mexico, too! Oh my goodness, you guys! So,
and if you're on Twitter, you can hashtag AskWendyLive.
Oh, you can, yes. Hashtag on Twitter, AskWendyLive. And, you know, we'll have all sorts of stuff up there. And Japan and Quebec. Oh, my goodness. The Philippines. Are you guys kidding me? And Missouri. That's where I grew up. Long, long ago. Okay, so. I'm kidding. I just wanted to see if you catch that.
You grew up in Ohio.
I know. I wanted to see if he was paying attention. Seattle, London, oh my goodness. Okay, let's get started, everyone, shall we? So, first of all, we had an amazing question sent in from Vicky Angel. I'm going to read that now. She wrote, I've been feeling lost over the last few months. I feel stuck and like I need a change in my life, but I don't know where to start. Any advice? That is a very good question. I think we've all felt that way before. I would say that whenever I'm there, I think the best way to start is to figure out where you want to go, you know, your end goal. And then from there, figure out a map to get there. It really helps and helps clarify kind of the path you need to take, because life is sort of a jungle that you just need to grab your machete and hack your own path through.
I do not approve of the use of machetes.
That's just in the jungle of life. Analogy.
Come on. I'm sorry.
I hope that helps a little bit. Let's see. Then we were written. Yes. Hi, Peter. Yes. So, let's see.
I have an ask. Oh, this is from Billy Jukes. She asked.
Oh, Billy, hi. I miss you.
Yeah, she says, how much do you miss me in Neverland?
Oh, tons. Not that, you know, you were a huge part of Neverland before you left, but you sure made an impression while you were here shortly. We miss you, especially here at the K-Cron. Joss and I, especially. I miss our game nights, and I can't wait to hear when you're coming back. Let's see. Oh, okay, so I have one here from Tiny Dancer, who writes, been an avid fan of your advice column, and I'm a fan of your book. Oh, thank you. I have been needing some advice about how to deal with a situation. That's what we do here. I'm a ballroom dancer, who has danced with the same partner for 10 years. Wow. We grew up in Neverland together and we're best friends. We even tried dating for about a year before I decided to go off to film school in California. We agreed to stay friends and see how it goes. That if it's meant to be, that we'll find our way back. It's hard for me to feel abandoned. It's hard for me not to feel abandoned and hard for me not to feel hurt. How do I deal with this? Yeah. Well, being apart from someone you love is hard. It is. But I think seeing someone you love be unhappy is harder. So my advice is to support him, support his dream, but not at the expense of your own. Make sure you're keeping yourself happy and pursuing your dreams. And, you know, school isn't forever. And I hear there's some great ballroom dancing in Los Angeles. But if for whatever reason it doesn't work out, make sure you're still taking care of yourself. But in general, I find it always best to play the grace card if you can, and try to put others first if you really love them. But not at the expense of yourself first. Wait, what? Me? Oh, that was ages ago. Let's see. Ooh, did you have one?
Yeah, okay, so here we have Mia to Neverland. She is asking Wendy, what is the best way to give bad news to a friend? And I'm going to answer, because I want to. It's all about making them a really big pizza. You give them the pizza, they're eating it, they're enjoying it, maybe they're having a little soda pop, and then, you know, you sort of slip of the bad news and everything's great.
That might work for a lot of things. I mean, I can definitely think of some situations in which pizza may not be the most appropriate response.
Oh, but you do have to know what toppings they like, because if you get the wrong toppings, then the whole plan...
You know what, I think you're onto something there, in that you at least, metaphorically, should...
For example, pizza with M&Ms. Now I know how to give her bad news. It's a great idea, and that's a great topping. That sounds delicious. Hmm.
It does come down to knowing your friends, and being open and honest. But I do find that being honest and not avoiding a topic is always the better route in the long run. Hello from, oh my goodness, all over the world, you guys! I'm so thrilled you tuned in. Okay, we have another one here. This one is from Carol. Hi, Carol. And it says, hello, Wendy. I was wondering what tips you have for those of us who are working on trying to build up more self-esteem and self-confidence. Thank you so much, XOXO. Whew, well, Carol, you know, I find that self-confidence and self-esteem, they tend to begin with self-acceptance. I mean, from there, after you love yourself and respect yourself, it all kind of flows. And I know that might sound easier than it actually is. But when I'm feeling down, because we all do, we're the hardest on ourselves, I think it's best to focus on the things you really do love about yourself, the things you're most proud of. And when you do that, you start to see the rest of yourself in a better light too. Whew, all right, let's see. Oh, I have another one here from Gemma Willow. Hi, Gemma. It says, oh my goodness, you guys. Thank you. Dear Wendy, I'm a writer and I've been experiencing a lot of writer's block lately. Been there. How do you get over it? Well, when I am experiencing writer's block, I find that I really just need to, you know, refill that old creative juices jug by just watching a lot of movies I love, or TV, reading books I love, comics, things that inspire you. Because a lot of times, seeing the wonderful stories other people are telling, or, I don't know, things that you'd never thought of before, they inspire you to come up with new things yourself.
Emily Dawn asks, well, who's your favorite person to dress up as? She misses...
Oh, she misses the costumes. Yes, as you realize, I was just told recently to maybe lay off said costumes, according to some focus groups. And I get it. I do. The professionalism is important. I also think sometimes just being true to yourself is the best. So let's see. What costumes do I love? Ugh! What don't I love? I love anything that involves a fantasy element. Some sort of time travel is always cool, other eras, and or impersonating a person specifically, because that's hilarious. And often a nice way to, you know, make a point through humor. Oh gosh, there's so many amazing questions coming in. Okay, Peter, help me.
I'm helping you. Okay, so there's a question from at Fish Girl Pond on Twitter.
Oh, what an amazing band.
I know. Their covers of the Mermaid Lagoon stuff is fantastic.
It is.
She asks, or they ask, do you ever wish that you had a sister?
A sister. You know, I was blessed with some really great brothers. So, I haven't missed a sister too much. I gotta say, I also grew up with a lot of great female friends. And so, I kind of got to choose my sisters in a way, which has been really wonderful. But I don't know. Gosh, it would be kind of fun. I really do like having siblings. You know, well, most of the time.
What about that one time that Michael dressed up like a girl? Does that count?
You know what? I think I might be okay without a sister. I've got two brothers, and they fill quite a gamut.
Oh, here's a question from Spellcaster Max. Who is your favorite hero or heroine who is not Peter Pan? I added that
last
part.
Did you write that? Okay. Well, I do love me some Doctor Who. Oh no, low battery. Let's see.
We're low battery.
We're gonna fix that real quick. Technical issues abound. I do love me some Doctor Who. Who else? Oh gosh. Do you remember The Last Unicorn? Oh, I loved that movie. And Labyrinth. Oh, I really was hoping that somebody might come kidnap Michael like the Goblin King and I could have to save him. Never happened. I have so many. I really was blessed to grow up at a time when we have so many amazing stories. Who are some of your favorites? Right? Isn't The Last Unicorn amazing? Also, Voltron. Big fan. I really think that I should have been Princess Aurora. Yeah, maybe in another life. Next life. My favorite doctor. Ooh. I gotta say, I think I'm a little partial to Matt Smith's doctor. David Tennant is a close.
I had a dentist named Dr. Chu.
Which is close to Doctor Who. All right, let's see. We have another question here from Amanda. Hello, Amanda. This says, I am feeling overwhelmed with responsibilities at the moment. How do you organize and prioritize your life? Whew, well, you know, actually, Amanda, I kind of think the answer to your question is in your question. I think, first of all, you should prioritize with a list. Prioritize all things you have going on, write them down, rank them, and then tackle them in that order. And realize that, you know what, you can't do everything, at least not in one day, but you know, you can get a lot done if you put your mind to it. Oh, and also don't forget to make some time for fun, because, I mean, after all, what good is life if you don't have a little bit of fun, right? Let's see.
Wendy.
Oh, yes.
I
have planners too, so many.
Jada Johnstone asks, what is your favorite Disney movie?
Oh, my favorite Disney movie. Oh, there's so many. Oh, golly. Such a tie. Well, having red hair, I was partial to Ariel for a while there, huh? I don't know. Do you guys have a favorite one? I just saw Pocahontas again. That was fun, but I don't think that's my favorite. How about you guys? My Hogwarts house. Well, I just took the test. Actually, I am a Hufflepuff. How about you guys? Favorite dessert? These really are ask me anything. I love creme brulee. I love it so much. I pretty much will order it anytime it's on the menu, and that may not be great for my waistline in the future. Oh, look at all of these amazing Hogwartians too. I love all of this pop culture crossover. Oh gosh, it's mostly Hogwarts sounding off right now. What other questions do we have? This one has, getting ready to go to college far away from your family and everyone you know, worried about starting over and missing home. That is always
an issue. Don't do
it.
Stay at home. I mean, this is your show, Wendy.
You will miss your friends and family, but the thing that's really amazing about college is that you make kind of a little pseudo-family there and friends that you're going to keep for the rest of your life. So don't be too afraid or focused on the fear part. Be focused on the excitement part, because I actually once found out, here, we'll do a little experiment to get it through. Everybody close your eyes for just a second, and I want you to feel as afraid as you possibly can. Picture just something that really scares you. Heights or driving really fast speeds around curves, whatever it is. Just picture it and get that feeling going a little bit in yourself. And then I want you to now switch and feel excited, like the most excited you've ever felt. Like you're about to wake up and go somewhere fantastic the next day, whatever it is. And realize that those two feelings actually are the same experience in your body. It's just, you know, your decision on how to approach it that colors the situation. So whenever you feel afraid, just decide to see it as excited instead. That's helped me a lot.
Anna Woods has a question that I absolutely have no answer to. Oh. She says that she procrastinates a lot, and then she feels guilty about it.
Yeah.
And then I forgot the second part of the question, but I think it was probably about, like, what do you do to not procrastinate?
To not procrastinate. Well, that is always an issue. I don't know that Peter should be handling this particular one.
You know, I love procrastinating, in fact. You know, the things I do to procrastinate are my PP reports, I get my work done the day before, and a whole bunch of other things.
Okay. I say, okay, yes, let's address the actual question. How to deal with procrastination? I like to give myself little tiny attainable goals within the larger goal. So if the larger goal is to get an entire paper done, and that's so much, I might say, okay, I'm going to write 2 paragraphs, and then I will allow myself 1x of procrastination, whatever that is, if it's a game that you're playing or something, and then keep that to, you know, a really short 5-minute increment, and then go back and do another 2 paragraphs. If you can do it in little sprints like that, you can get anything done.
No. Oh, so you like making up little games to help the time pass?
I do.
Okay. Alexis Pritchard has a question from the Twitter.
Oh, hello, Alexis.
I'm currently in 3 theater productions.
Whoa.
And have no time for my friends.
Yeah, how do you do that?
First of all, love theater.
It's amazing.
Great, nice work. Love it.
That's a lot.
How do
of
I let them
head.
Know I still love and care about them?
Oh, well, if your friends are true friends, they're going to understand, and they're going to support your dream too. And honestly, these theater productions will end. They're not forever, so hopefully they're understanding. But in the meantime, I would say just make sure you communicate the fact that you are really stretched thin right now to them, and tell them that even though you are, you still love them and are thinking about them, even if it's just, you know, a text or a little social media shout out that you send them. Let them know you can't wait to make it up to them as soon as the production's over.
And invite them to the show, and then when they come to see the show, like, you know, take them out to a diner or something and let them tell you how fabulous you are.
Sure.
That's a great way to keep your friends.
It is always fun to come out of a stage production and have your friends waiting there for you, congratulating you. Let's see. If I could go anywhere in the world, where would I want to go? Oh, so many places. I mean, granted, I have gotten to see a lot in the last year, which has been amazing, but there are still so many I'd like to see. I'd really like to see Venice. I've never been there, and it looks beautiful. Or Hawaii. I've actually never been there, or anywhere remotely tropical. So, like, Tahiti? I don't know. Where would you guys like to go? Favorite musical? Oh, that changes all the time. There's so many good ones. I got to be in Greece in our Neverland High production. That was fun. Played Frenchie. That was the definite favorite for a few years there. Although, you know, right now everybody's really into Hamilton. It's pretty rad. Also, Wicked is a great one I've seen. Oh gosh, so many. I do love London. I would love to go back. Somebody asked that. Oh, New Zealand. Yes, that's where Hobbit's.
That's Hobbit, yeah.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. That would be lovely.
I'd like if New Zealand came and visited us here in Neverland. Winslow has there's a guy named, someone named Winslow who has a question.
Winslow, yes.
They've never been an early riser, but they have class at 8:30 a.m., which is inhuman. Why would that ever happen? And Winslow was asking if you had any advice about getting up so early.
It is tough. Although it is something that most people have to deal with at some point in their life, be it via a job or school or parenting eventually. So I understand that is a very human feeling. I find that giving myself something to look forward to first thing in the morning is a good way to help. Be it a really good cup of coffee or, I don't know, just some music or a radio station that I just love gives me a little bit of something extra to get out of bed for. Maybe I start the day with a hot shower. Give yourself a little bit of something wonderful to wake up to and then and enough time to do so. And I think your day will take a slightly brighter turn. And really getting into the habit of it sets your body to do so more often.
Oh, this is a good one, and one I want to hear, and okay. It's putting you on the spot.
Oh, boy.
Simply Shelb says, what is one of your favorite memories with Peter, that's me, that you haven't told anybody before?
I haven't told anybody.
Or, you know, at least, you know, on your videos.
Let's see.
It better be good, too.
You know, I guess I gotta say, although I may have told some of you this, just that first day that we really became friends, you know, that you took me and my brothers out all over Neverland. I didn't even realize that our hometown could be so exciting.
Oh, yeah.
And you had a whole adventure plotted just at the drop of a hat.
I do like my tours of Neverland on Founders Day.
Oh, it was fantastic. It opened up my eyes to what everyday life could be.
Yeah, I remember that time that we went hiking up to Bear Rock.
Oh,
we hiked up there,
no.
And Michael was so out of breath. It was really funny. But she was a trooper. I mean, she went in safari outfit, and it was
prepared.
Really hilarious. It was like she had some canteens, which was good because I got thirsty. But that was
the
fun.
The fireflies hiking down
were
so
great.
Pretty.
We are on this, so we should keep working.
Okay, yes. We will keep answering these questions. Let's see. Peter, will you do a group tour of Neverland for all residents next Founders Day? Oh, well, depends what his work schedule is. But wouldn't that be amazing? It's a great idea. I'll bring it up to him. Let's see. Oh, these are going so fast. Hello. I'm looking to study abroad this summer, but I'm not sure. Oh, no, that went away. Oh,
what went away?
Somebody help.
Your phone?
A question. No,
your question. What was the... Do you know anything
something
about
Something about studying abroad.
Studying abroad.
But let's see.
Is she cute?
They're all adorable. Are you kidding? Any of our fans are pretty much the best people
no,
around.
No, the broad that she's studying.
Oh.
Oh, that's crude. Oh, she's studying abroad this summer, but she's not sure if the program you're applying to is the right one. Any advice?
I can see how that would be a problem. You're open to the whole world. How do you choose where to go? It's going to color the rest of your life in some way. But
you go to Neverland, Ohio. That's the only answer.
Here's my advice. There's no wrong answer. Wherever you choose is going to be the best place for you. So go where you feel your heart has always kind of drawn you. I usually tend to find in these instances that my heart already knows the answer, whether or not I want to admit it in my head. So where you really picture yourself, go there. And it's going to end up being the right place wherever it is.
I'd never land Ohio because that's the only right place. I have a question here from... I can't read my own handwriting.
Oh.
Kara Zenith.
Oh,
on
Kara.
On the Twitter. What superpower would you most want, and what's the first thing you would do with it?
Oh, superpower. Who's to say I don't have one? I would want... Yeah, it's not that exciting, but I really like the idea of flying.
I love flying.
I mean, honestly, isn't that exciting? You could just travel somewhere quickly without having to find a parking spot or, you know, have to deal with things like oil changes and car insurance. I don't know. It sounds great. And also, I would want to fly but be strong enough to help someone else fly too so you're not flying alone. I don't know. For now. Tomorrow might be a different answer.
Sarah Isabel says, you are amazing.
Sarah, you are.
That's not a question.
Oh. Let's see. All right, help me out here, K-Kron Tech Crew / Mr. Pan. They're flying in.
Oh, we have a question from G. Darling, EIC. Oh, that's your dad.
Dad?
He asks, your mother and I are bound for Hawaii soon.
Ugh, so jealous.
Do you want me to bring you something? Over. Roger that, George.
Hi, Dad. I would love you to. Let's see. I hear they have some amazing chocolates there, like macadamia chocolates, or also like orchid soap. You know what? Could you just bring me like orchid something? Or are you not allowed to take those on a plane? Maybe like a cool little necklace.
Hey, Georgie, can you get me one of those coconut monkeys? That'd be awesome. I could put that right in my pan cave. Oh, that would be amazing.
Oh, here was a good one. How does my relationship with my brothers change as we get older? Well, there's usually less fighting or bickering from when you were actual kids, and you become, you're part of each other's living diaries. So you realize that you're going to be your longest running friends in life, and that's important. I'm really lucky to have the brothers I have. They're such a great support system. I hope I am to them. And it changes all the time, but I think it grows stronger. Let's see. Who is my favorite black historical figure? Oh my goodness. There are so many, and so many that aren't rightfully recognized. I would say... Rosa Parks is huge. I mean, there's so many that made such a great difference. Who's yours? I want to know someone that I haven't ever known. You know who my answer is? Those women at NASA that they just made the entire movie Hidden Figures about. They are amazing, and we need to know more about them. I want to see a documentary. I love the movie, but I want to see those actual
women. I thought that movie was a documentary.
Yes. Okay. Let's see. Oh gosh, they're coming in very quickly. How can I improve my relationship with my brother? Oh, well, not knowing you nor your brother or your particular relationship, I'm gonna kind of guess here. I would say any relationship can be improved by listening. So be sure to listen to each other and your interests and your needs, and try to be there for each other, because ultimately you're the only ones that'll ever know what it was like to grow up in your household. You know, you're the only ones that did. So come from it with love, and I think that should hopefully be a good start. Let's see. Ooh, these are some amazing people you're putting forward. Thank you for all these suggestions about the people to look into. I can't wait to read about them. Let's see. I see a different background. Oh, okay. How do I keep in contact with my long-distance best friend? Oh, I do have some experience with that.
You send messages via owl, right?
If you have a very reliable owl, sure.
I did, but she didn't come back. I guess it's not reliable.
Right. I mean, luckily today we live in an age where you can communicate instantaneously with texts or social media or email. But gosh, isn't it wonderful to get an actual letter in the mail? Try to remember each other's birthdays or special events and send a card every now and then, or a care package. Something I loved doing with my best friend when we lived apart was to send a rainy day package, which is just a box full of lots of tiny wrapped presents. Like, I mean, little things like their favorite chapstick or favorite gum. And then the rule is that anytime there's a rainy day or they're feeling down, they get to open one of them and know that you're thinking about them. That helped.
This is a good question for you, Wendy.
Okay.
Melissa says... She used to live in Los Angeles, mm-hmm. and had the best time of her life. She had to move back to Milwaukee, and she misses who she was there, presumably in Los Angeles. Any advice on moving back home?
Wow. Well, I can relate a little bit to that. It is amazing to live in a big city, and it can be an adjustment to move back home. I would say... realize you haven't lost yourself or your ability to stay in contact with the world at large. You're still the same you. I would say make time to bring some of that cosmopolitanness to your small town, if you can. And make time to travel. Oh, somebody had a question about how to save money.
Not for me. you take this one.
I would say the best way is to start paying yourself first. That means every month, just set up an automatic savings out of an account where, like, however much it is you think you can afford, whether it's just $10 or if it's $100 or whatever it is, and make sure you pay that automatically into a savings account. Like, just set it up to do it without thinking. And then you'll see it start to grow pretty quickly. I know that's boring, but it actually works really well. Pay yourself first.
There's a question now via the Twitter from @SeanIsRight, but it's not right as in correct, it's right as in writing. He asks, pie or cake?
Oh. Huh. I guess it's pie or cake dependent. Like, depends on the pie or the cake. Some cakes.
Okay, favorite pie, favorite cake.
A German chocolate cake's pretty good.
Whoa, that was fast.
Mm. And pie. Oh, there's so many good pies.
My favorite, hands down, is strawberry cake.
You're allergic.
Oh. Yeah, that's true.
To strawberries.
I just like normal cake. You're on it.
He was testing. But yes, it is very good. Sorry, I can't enjoy it. I mean, he has enjoyed it a time or two, but the results have been hilarious. Oh, there was something about cheek implants. I don't have cheek implants. Do I need them? I think my cheeks are pretty...
They're great.
Puffy. Should I take an unpaid internship abroad? Oh, golly, that would be really hard, unless you had a lot of money saved up to live off of. I find unpaid internships are rough, unless they're very short-term and local. Although experience is vital, try to look for other things, because there's always going to be another opportunity.
At Danger Teddy on the Twitter, that's
my Michael. Brother.
Yeah, he's asking where the remote is.
Michael, how should I know where you put the remote? I'm going to guess, oh gosh, it's Michael. Check the freezer.
Oh. Also check your feelings, monster. It might be in there.
Oh, yeah. Sometimes he stuffs it in there. It's weird. Oh, man. Let's see. Next one, sir. Let's see. I'm scared to leave my small town to pursue my dreams because it means leaving my friends. So, like, my family, what do I do? Your friends will love you no matter what. I say follow your dreams. I mean... And you know what? You might make some even better friends or new friends to add into the fold. You never know. Don't limit yourself. I know that you can always come back home.
Clearly. As I did.
Sussy. Oh, they're flying in rather quickly. Hello! The scariest thing I've ever done. Oh. Well, relating to the last question, I would say leaving home was the scariest thing I'd ever done. It was everything I knew and, you know, going into something... A situation with people I didn't know was terrifying, but it was also exciting, and it really helped me grow as a person, and I wouldn't be here without having taken that leap, so scariest, but amazing.
Oh, I forgot who said that.
How to deal with feelings of jealousy or anxiety when your friends start to become more, cut off. Do you have a good one?
Yeah, sorry. Anna Woods says, I feel like I might be growing apart from my friends.
Oh.
How can I tell them?
You know, that can happen. Everybody, relationships change over time. I don't know that there's really a need to tell them.
Oh, you could get them a really big pizza with their favorite toppings. And, you could even spell the toppings out.
See how things go, and if you really are not happy with that outcome, make an effort to put yourself in each other's lives more. But if you're okay with growing apart, then let the growing apart happen. It does over time. It doesn't mean you're any less friends. I have friends that I haven't hung out with daily for even years, and yet still I know if I ever need to, I can call them up, and it's like we've been We start off right where we left off.
All right. Eric Lafferty. Oh, the Twitter handle is Laughing Tree.
Oh, that's cute.
Yeah, if you were in a tree, that would... Okay. How do you know when it's time to give up on something? I would say that when the pizza has been sitting on your sofa for 4 months...
What?
No, that's not long enough.
That is too long. To survive if you eat it. That's disgusting. And I would have cleaned it up for you if I'd ever seen that happen. Oh my goodness. When is it too long to give... Can you repeat the question, Peter? I think your pizza thing threw me off.
I know, right?
When do you know when it's time to give up on something? Was that it?
Yeah. You had it.
If something is hurting you or causing you to maybe... veer off from what you know is true about yourself, your core values, your goals. I think, although maybe realizing it is the hardest thing, is important to do. You need to realize it and then take that first step. And after that, everything becomes a lot easier. I hope that helps.
Bittersweet Sorrows asks,
"Whoa, what a name.
Pirates or ninjas?" And I want to clarify the question. Space pirates or space ninjas?
Well, to what, though? To fight or to team up with? Because I'm going to take pirates if I have to fight them. I don't want to fight ninjas. But if I have to join them, I don't know that I'm qualified to be a ninja.
Isn't that the best answer you've ever heard?
Pirates? Mermaids? Oh, golly, you guys. Let's see. Whoa, they're going so fast. What is the difference between regular space ninjas? Oh, well, they're in space. That's the only difference. My ex wants me to come back. Oh, gosh, they're going so fast I can't read them. I'm going to have to rely on you,
Mr. Fan. I read one about
pizza.
No, someone said something about whether I like pineapple on my pizza. No, that's an abomination.
It is delicious.
No.
And it is one of the best toppings. I will eat just pineapple on a pizza if I have a choice. Would you want to be a dragon rider? Yes. That's the easy answer. I mean, unless the dragon is, you know, a real jerk.
Yeah.
Right.
Right.
Yeah, make sure you like the dragon.
Yeah.
Okay.
Music Angel, and then four numbers, asks, what is your perfect day?
Oh.
That's a good one.
My perfect day. Well, it's not getting up too early. I do enjoy a little bit of that sleeping in action, but I don't want to sleep too late until you know, that point where you start to feel guilty. So, you know, getting up at the perfect time, having a leisurely, wonderful brunch with friends at a new and exciting venue because you're in a brand new city, about to have an adventure and explore somewhere that you've never seen before, and then taking a little afternoon siesta or rest and enjoying a good book, and then a fantastic dinner later on with only just a few friends, maybe one or two or three, a smaller group, and talking long into the night, maybe watching a movie to end things off. I'm pretty easy. Am I lame? Maybe I'm too old now. Should I do something more exciting?
No, that's pretty great.
That sounds like a wonderful day to me. Yeah, today, anyway. Let's see. Do I have any office decorations I made myself? I think I do. Let me see. I made a couple of these things. Well, oh, you know what? I actually helped with those. We helped, we took those years ago, and then we kind of aged the frames up a little bit. I don't know. Oh, we have a friend here, Katie Moest, that helps us make a lot of stuff, though, and most of it, I have to confess, she's made because she's a lot better at it than I am. Let's see.
Okay, I'm sorry. Rebecca asked me a question. This is now Ask Peter Live. All right, she says, oh, what did she say? She said, what is it like working as an adult?
Ah.
Do I still have time for fun? And I have to tell you, it has been so fun playing as being an adult. And what I do is I go to work.
Yes.
And I'm awesome. I do all of my work things and then I go home and I get to have my pan cave where I can
fun,
yeah,
right?
Yeah, it's fun. I get to have fun on the nights and the weekends like normal people. And I think that's a great thing to do.
And sometimes at work, we've had fun.
Sure.
Sometimes.
Yeah. I mean, you know, just the other day, John taught me the joys of an Excel spreadsheet.
Oh.
And that was great. I'm still talking. This is me. I got to change all the cells into different colors. Some were green, some were blue, some were pink. And then I could change the text to be whatever color I wanted. It was great. And also incredibly productive.
I'm surprised that was fun for you, but happily surprised. I'm happily surprised. Let's see. They're flying in fast. Do you do journaling, and what advice do you have for a beginner? I do. I write a lot, clearly, I guess. So I tend to just jot down little ideas throughout the day in a book and sticky notes all over to myself. And then at the end of the day, I'll kind of compose them into my official diaries. Just to keep my thoughts kind of sorted.
Anna Woods asks, if you ever need to ask anybody for advice. You give a lot of other people advice.
I do. I think I do. I've asked, asked quite a few people for advice. I've asked Billy for advice a lot. I've asked my brothers on occasion, my dad, my mom, more my dad than my mom. And sometimes I've asked you guys. You've helped. You know, Lily's given me some very interesting advice on occasion. But yes.
I think I'm going to start giving advice.
I think you should. But yes, of course, I do. And sometimes I just read other advice columns for some inspiration. Oh, gosh. Oh, you're welcome. Golly, what is my go-to comfort food?
Ooh. Pizza, apparently with pineapples, which is just the pizza. Most disgusting. It's an abomination.
It's delicious. I also like spaghetti. Apparently, I like red sauce a lot. Pancakes? Pancakes are good. I hear that there's butterbeer pancakes, like they exist in the world and I need to find them. The end.
That sounds delicious. Okay. Joe Watson on the Twitter asks, what is the first step to changing your life for the better? She also says hi to me. And to that, I say, hello.
Changing your life for the better. Well, not knowing where you're starting out or what needs changing, that is a little harder to answer. But I would say in general, as we advise somebody else, it's best to know where you want to end up. And if you know where you want to end up, it's easier to make a map to get there. So whatever in your life doesn't look the way you want it to, figure out what you want it to look like.
Cover your ears. I would say to change your socks and your underwear. That's a good first step.
That's an important step you should do every day. Let's see. Somebody is saying how to act like Hook. Oh. Like Joss?
Oh, you should see my videos. Peter's Panels. I show you how to act like a real Hook.
Well, I have seen those, and I think that you're acting like a long ago him, and it maybe is a less adult-y version of Peter.
That's fair.
So, you... He's actually rather accessible. You could ask him on Twitter what might make him tick.
Oh. Zafjaff asks how Neverland is responding to the changes at the K-Kron. And I've seen lots of comments. We have an article on the KensingtonChronicle.com. Oh, fellow subscribers, that it's called The Never Speak, and that sort of summarizes what happens every week. And
right. It's a lovely gossip column. They really summarize a lot of what goes on here.
Brought to you by JH Media.
Yes.
I'm required to say that every hour.
Everybody deals with it differently. I think most people are adjusting very well. Some people, it's taking them a little longer. But you know what? We're all happy to be here and really addressing media in the new age. Let's see. Let's see. Favorite ice cream flavor. Ooh. Anything with toffee in it tends to be my favorite. Although sometimes just chocolate. Like as chocolate as you can possibly pack into one particular bite is sometimes my go-to. But again, if I can combine my favorite dessert of creme brulee with ice cream, winning. I can't read these so quickly. Let's see.
My favorite color, green.
Mine is holographic. That's a color. It's all the colors.
I like the way you think.
Yeah. Let's see. I've got my end. Oh, these are going very quickly again.
Don't disinfect the Chronicle. We have to infect the Chronicle.
Wait,
what's
what?
The opposite of disinfect?
They want the pan punch recipe.
Oh, they want the pan punch? That is a secret...
family recipe?
I was going to say family, but isn't it?
You made it up.
Don't bring up family. It's a little of this, little of that.
Perhaps.
The tears of a mermaid, the sweat of a pirate, and a little bit of fairy dust.
Perhaps if you keep asking, he'll reveal them sometime in the future.
Ask me on Twitter.
Oh, my goodness. Let's see. Cats or dogs? Oh, well, I like both a lot. But currently, I am wearing a cat shirt. So maybe today cats? Oh, my goodness.
On the Twitter, Lonesome Whale asks,
hello, Lonesome Whale.
When you were young, what did you guys want to be when you grew up?
Oh. Well, I wanted to be a unicorn doctor, president, astronaut, fashion designer.
I wanted to work at JH Media.
No, you did not.
I have to say it every, like, 5 minutes.
I don't think that's contractually obligated, Peter.
I don't understand the question, because...
I wanted to be something that obviously you can't get paid to do, but I gotta say, I am really happy with what I did get to grow up to be, and I think that there's a way for everybody to follow your dreams, although scary at first, and often not financially productive in the beginning, it's well worth it to live that life.
Jane Mannering on Twitter asks, what is the question to the ultimate question of life, the universe and everything? 42.
I'm going to have to get back to you on that. I sure haven't figured it out. But I think not knowing might be sort of the fun. TARDIS phone case. Yes, yes, he does have a TARDIS phone case. We share a love of Doctor Who. Let's see. Do I have any interview tips? I haven't had to interview too many people, although I hope to maybe start doing that someday. Let's see. I would say make sure that you have done a little research on the person you're interviewing so you don't come off as not knowing them. And, you know, knowing their background, things that might be triggers for them to avoid or if you really want to delve into them, depending on the type of interviewing you're doing. And to give them a chance to talk. The interviewer should not be dominating, although helping to steer the conversation. Let's see, fantasy or sci-fi? Both. They should always live together, I think. What is your favorite thing about Peter Pan? Ugh.
Oh, I love this question. Who asked that question? And, you know, feel free to not limit yourself to more than 10 things that are great about me.
I love Peter's zest for life and his ability to always make things fun and find an adventure. That is one of my favorite things.
My favorite thing about Peter Pan now is that I work at JH Media.
Okay,
Hooked on media.
Hello, Brazil. Let's see. When are Peter's panels coming back? I feel like Peter might be hijacking this Ask Wendy Skosh. I don't know. If we have... that on the agenda for the K-Cron. But you know what? I'll be sure to ask Joss and talk to Peter. Peter, I'm sure there'd be some deadlines involved.
I'm working on some advertisements right now.
Hello,
Marooners Munchies needs an advertisement selling their you know, the downtown bake sale.
Yeah.
And so I'm tasked with drawing the advertisements.
Do I believe in love at first sight? No, not really love. I think that needs to be a little bit of something that grows. Although the spark for love can definitely be there. The interest, the chemistry can be there. But I think love should be a little bit of a choice. And you know, also half listening to your heart. I don't know.
Someone asked about what our patronus would be, our patroni.
Oh, patroni. I think a bird.
Yeah.
Like a swallow or something.
Mine would be J.M. Barrie.
Wait.
Yeah, you can have people? Awesome people as your patroni.
We'll ask JK that on Twitter and see if she agrees. Let's see. Oh, they're flying so fast. Any advice for first-time flyers, like on a plane? Oh my goodness. Take a good book. Maybe bring some snacks because, you know, they usually charge for those now. A blanket or something you can roll up to use as a pillow. And just, you know, relax and realize that it's safer than driving.
Aaron Fishman, you were not done. Aaron Fishman asks, what is your favorite thing about Joss? CEO of JH Media, get hooked on media.
About Joss, his ability to dream big and to help other people realize their dreams too. If I could pick your name, what would it be? Oh, if I could pick a new name. You know, that's changed throughout my life. There was a time growing up where I really wanted it to be Crystal because I thought that sounded like it would be more in a fantasy movie than Wendy. And then, you know, for a while, I think I had some very interesting ones like Ruby. I guess gem-centric names for a while. but right now, I really like Wendy.
On the Twitter, Angelique Toski asks,
hello, Angelique.
What is your opinion on sweet potato toast? She's asking for a friend, and I'll tell you that friend is not me, because I want to know nothing about potatoes that are sweet in the shape of toast.
Oh, you know what a sweet potato is.
Sweet potato toast.
I don't know if I've ever had sweet potato toast. I love sweet potato fries and sweet potato casserole.
That ruins normal fries.
No, it doesn't.
It does. The mere existence of sweet potato fries ruins everything that is...
Oh, my goodness. I think I would be willing to try it. Are you making some, Angelique? Let's see. Oh, she'll post the recipe. All right. Let's do it.
All right. Musical Micah 99 on the Twitter asks, any relationship advice? How should I tell someone I love them?
Oh.
You buy them a giant pizza.
I'm sensing a theme here.
Okay, I'm sorry. Okay.
How should you tell someone you love them? Hopefully, you know the person well enough to know when the right time would be to do so. And I think a lot of it's going to depend on the person you're telling. Some people like grand gestures and, you know, public announcements, and others like personal, intimate moments. So make sure you know the person, hopefully, if you love them, and craft it to them, whatever you think would mean the most to them.
Danny has asked me whether my pizza is thin crust pizza or thick crust pizza.
Ooh.
And that is a weird question, because... why not have both? I put my thin crust pizza right on top of that thick crust pizza, put it on top of a deep dish, and man, that is a Neverland slice.
I have seen him do that. I, you know what? It kind of varies for me. I haven't met too many pizzas I don't like, so I am not.
I've met a pizza decisive. That I didn't like. It had pineapple on it. It is an abomination.
And I ate it all. Okay, so, hi from Texas. Hello. This guy.
Oh. Hmm. Abigail Rose has a good question for you.
Abigail.
She asked, do you miss having long hair? She cut her hair into a pixie cut and feels super self-conscious right now.
Oh, I remember that on occasion. The initial chop does leave one feeling a little bare as you get used to it. And then I feel like there's a certain level that it gets to that you're just like, this is amazing. I don't have to do hardly anything and it feels great. And then it starts to get long again, and then you want it longer, and then you want it shorter because you cut it again. It's a weird conundrum with hair. In general, I find that I feel more like I am a short hair person right now. So sometimes I miss it, but usually right now I think I'm spot on.
Someone just reminded me that there is a thing called stuffed crust pizza. And so what I will do is I will take my previous concoction of the Neverland slice and I shall stuff that into the crust of a normal slice of pizza. And that will be
That sounds like a noble effort for tonight.
That sounds like something that I should leave in pants, Dave. I'm sorry. If you're just now tuning in, this is Ask Wendy Live at JH Media.
Occasionally, we should maybe have called it Ask Wendy and Peter.
Sure. Well, I just...
All the carbs. That's what it sounds like. It sounds like all the carbs.
The camera's right there. You can't expect
heart
me
attack,
not to.
Pizza. Sure. Yeah. That's, you know, you should do a lot of working out if that's what you're eating. Indeed. Oh, some people are asking about the anybody saying mean comments in here. Just ignore them. They're just looking for attention. You know, they probably need a hug. I hope they get it, but if not, ignore them. Do you guys ever play board games at the office when you're on break? Of course. You know what? We haven't, but that could be interesting to maybe do like a Wednesday happy hour after work, or maybe lunchtime break board game room. We just have to check and see if it, you know, gels with the productivity spreadsheets that Smee's made. Oh, my teeth are perfect. Oh, no, they're not. And I definitely had braces for a long time. And I whitened them. Thank you, though. Let's see. My friends ask advice and expect good advice. That went too fast. I need to be a speed reader. How do you mend a broken heart, Peter? Peter?
What? What?
How do you mend a broken heart?
You eat a lot of pizza. Duct tape?
Time. Oh. Time is the best mender. for that. Let's see, what else? School advice. School in general? Which school to go to? What would you like? Let's see. If you could have any, what superpower would you choose? Oh, we addressed that. Flight for now. I think
what
it changes
often. Are your thoughts about John and Smee?
Oh. Oh. Well, they might be watching this. I don't want to give too much away. I love them both. Of course I love my brother. I'm always going to be on my brother's side, and I want him ultimately to be happy. So whatever makes John happy, I am for. I do think Mr. Smee is a fantastic person. And I love him too.
And he is one of my bosses here at JH Media. Hooked on media.
How's Tinkerbell? She's great. She's been away for a little while.
No, Tinkerbell's great. She and I hang out at the cave.
Well, she hasn't been around the Cacron.
No, oh yeah. She was part of Disinfect Chronicle, which I'm not supposed to talk about here on the air.
I believe she's great. She's seen a little preoccupied to me lately. I think she's dealing with something. I don't know. If you follow her on Twitter, I think there might be some good insight there.
Yeah, at tbells01.
Was that Z with Bells with a Z or S?
S.
S, of course. Sorry. I mean, I follow her.
You know it's her because her cover photo has a picture of a Ken doll surrounded by hearts.
Ah, and she speaks in emojis online. That's true, which makes sense for her.
Music Angel asks, Wendy, what would your theme song be?
Oh. My theme song. Oh, golly. You know what? I gotta say, it would probably be orchestral and would not have words because the words would have to change all the time. Something peppy, a little quirky, mostly upbeat with, you know, some heart underneath it. I don't know. Do you guys want to write me one?
I have a question, but I'm not going to reveal the person who it is. I'm going to use a synonym. This person's name rhymes with Fawn Glee. Mr. Glee, he asks, what kind of wine will make someone forgive you?
Mm-hmm. Well, Mr. Glee, I don't think there's a particular type of wine that's a magic serum like that. Unfortunately, gosh, wouldn't it be nice? I think forgiveness takes time, honesty, addressing the issue.
Well, Mr. Glee, why don't you come on down to Ye Old Pan Cave and I will show you a concoction that will knock your socks off. It's called Pan Punch and it's delicious. You come drink that and we'll talk.
I think in this case you should take Peter's advice. Let's see, how is Michael doing? Michael's great. He's giving tours at the Garden of Light, which I think he's going to do a free one for you guys online if you follow along pretty soon. I think he just announced it on the K-Cron. He's happy. He's really happy with Lily. So weird, but wonderful at the same time. And you know what? I think they're really good for each other. Oh, hi, Riggs 469. Let's see. Is it legal? Is Pan Punch legal?
In Neverland, Ohio, it is.
Yes, we do have some rather lenient laws when it comes to concoctions. I don't know where you're from. Possibly? I mean, mostly, right?
Someone's asked... Oh, this is horrible. Someone has asked me what happens if I cannot get pizza. I would invent pizza.
There we go. Yes. Solve your own problems. That's always a good advice. let's see. Do we like our Indiana neighbors? Sure, of course. Yes, we like people from all over. People are on a, you know, per person basis, obviously, but they're pretty wonderful everywhere we've met them from. Let's see. How do you deal with feelings of jealousy and anxiety when your friends start becoming more successful than you? Oh. Well, I have met some very successful people lately. It's a very human emotion, but I think the thing to realize is that their success doesn't make it not your success. It's not a pie. Them having it doesn't mean that you don't get to have it too. So just be happy for them. Your success is always going to seem sweeter if you're happy for others too.
Jay Feinstein asks,
hello, Jay.
Have you ever had any pets? And
I have.
Yeah.
Yeah, we grew up with Nana. Our dog was our family dog was amazing. In fact, we've had about four Nanas because we really liked the name. So every time one would pass away, we'd get another one. Is that weird? Anyway, no. We've also had cats, and we've had a ferret briefly. You know, a lot of them were things that Michael just brought home, if I'm being honest.
That's
like
fair.
Every summer. But I like animals. Oh, I'm so sorry. I do talk very quickly. Someone asked if I'd speak slower. I have a very high voice, and it's very fast.
Dweeby Blurtler? Hmm? Blurter, I love that. I love that. Asks, who is your role model other than Peter Pan? I may have added that last bit.
I have a lot of role models. Not all of them are real people. Some are fictional because I think that is just as admirable to have. I mean, Princess Leia, does it get cooler of a role model than that? I think women and men who are brave and intelligent and a little funny tend to be characters that I look up to. Although I think it's better to not just have one role model and just like one person that you want to model your life after. I like to have a hodgepodge. You can kind of squish together and borrow bits from in your inspiration. Does that help? Yes, you're right, General Leia at this point. What point are we in exactly? It's hard to tell where we're watching when. I'm getting very time lordy on the whole Star Wars universe. Anyway, okay, do I watch Sherlock? I have not, although I've watched the trailers for it, and it looks like something I would enjoy because I like Benedict Cumberbatch. He's amazing.
No, Sherlock is amazing.
But I have so little time lately to catch up on stuff. It's really hard. But I do. I like so many shows and so many movies. Let's see. Which book do you wish you could read again, like it was the first time? Oh, the Harry Potter books are fantastic, aren't they? I do. I find them exciting every time I have read them. There's so many good books. Oh, gosh. Everyone. I wish every book I could reread like the first time. The Outlander books are good, too. Are you ever too old for cartoons? No!
No!
What a silly question. Never! Enjoy all of them, although, you know, some you can like more than others.
Megan Otto on the Twitter asks, any advice for a soon-to-be college grad about to start her career?
Oh. Yes. Realize that your first job is not going to be your final job or the one you have to stay in forever. So make the most of it for now, and realize your whole life is ahead of you. You can still plot the adventure any which way you want to go. Enjoy it, make new friends, and make the story yours. And congratulations! It's a big achievement. Let's see, pizza or tacos? Oh.
That's not even a question.
I guess pizza, but oh, tacos are so good too.
How about a pizza taco? Or just throw that out there. Why do you have to be so this or that?
Or like a potluck where everybody brings all
pizzas.
Sorts of things, including pizzas
sure.
and tacos.
Yeah. Did you answer all of these?
I have.
You did? Okay.
Let's see. I was a tour guide in college. That was your first job? Oh, congrats. Well, the Garden of Light is actually, I think, hiring, or maybe we'll be again. Stay tuned. Who knows? It always is. I have got, oh, these are going so quickly. Yes.
One more question.
Oh, we only have time for one more? Oh my goodness, this has gone so quickly, you guys. Thank you for joining me on this. Let's see. They're flying through. I need a really good one for the last one, guys. Oh gosh, these are so quick. Okay, come on. Think of something fantastic. Mermaids or fairies?
I have a good one.
That's
who said that one?
I would, well.
Oh.
It flew by. Although, I've met some kind of mean fairies and some kind of mean mermaids.
Heavenly Imaginings asks,
yes.
Is it ever too late to chase your dreams?
No. It's never too late to chase your dreams. I think that as long as you're still having them, you're old enough to start chasing them.
And a great way to chase your dreams is here at JH Media, where you can get hooked on media.
Well, it can certainly be a good resource for finding out more. Oh, my goodness. Well, thank you so much, all of my Wendy Birds, for joining me on this Ask Wendy Live. It's been exciting and scary and fun. I'm sorry if I speak so fast. I'm so impressed that so many of you from all over the world tuned in and shared so many questions and insight and inspiration in some of your comments. And I look forward to hearing more of them. You can always reach us on Twitter or at the KCRON. So stay tuned. We have a lot more coming at you. Did you want to say goodbye, Peter?
Well, I have to figure out how to turn this thing off. So, yeah.
Okay.
All right. So I'm going to take this now. Bye, everybody. This is great. Let's see here. I think I pressed this. Are you sure you want to stop streaming? Yes. That's it.